गुड मॉर्निंग, लेट अस फर्स्ट टॉक अबाउट द सिलेबस फॉर फोर्थ सेमिस्टर। एक्चुअली सिलेबस इज ऑलरेडी सेंड टू यू। आई वॉन्ट टू डिस्कस द सिलेबस फर्स्ट, आफ्टर दैट वी कैन start the syllabus. We are going to start the syllabus because there is sufficient time available before your examination. Your examinations are going to start in the last week of February. Till then we have a lot of time, so let us utilize this time to complete some portion of fourth semester. Then after your examination we will go for remaining part. As you know, there are two theory papers for fourth semester, optics and lasers will be taught to you by Pawan. That is paper number 8. I am going to teach you paper number 9, basic electronics. Name of paper is basic electronics. Actually you are having PDF of syllabus of BSc second year. Paper number 9, basic electronics for fourth semester. In this semester I will teach paper number 9. Paper number 8 will be taught by Pawan. At the same time he will also teach you SEC. Most of the syllabus of SEC is based on optics and lasers. So these two papers will be taught by Pawan. As usual, the paper I am going to teach you is for 50 marks. 40 marks will be for end semester examination. 10 marks will be for CA, continuous assessment. There are 4 units. Unit number 1, if you go to the old syllabus, you will find that unit number 1 is regulator power supplies. For your syllabus, unit number 1 is not regulated power supplies. Regulated power supplies is replaced by semiconductor diodes. In this unit, we have to study what is semiconductor, what is definition of semiconductor, what material we can call as a semiconductor, some important properties of a semiconductor. After that, we shall discuss types of semiconductors. Broadly, there will be 2 types: intrinsic semiconductors and extrinsic semiconductors. Extrinsic semiconductors will be further divided into 2 categories, N-type and P-type. I think you might have studied this part in earlier classes. Whatever, we are going to study this. After that, we shall go for study of simple PN junction diode, which is just a rectifier diode, IV characteristics of this diode. Then we shall go for study of Zener diode and its IV characteristics, light emitting diode, its IV characteristics, photodiode, its IV characteristics, varector diode and its IV characteristics. So, after study of types of semiconductors, we have to study about 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 different types of diodes and their IV characteristics. That will complete first unit of paper number 9. Then second unit of this paper is about bipolar junction transistors or BJT. What thing we have to study in BJT? First of all, I will tell you general information about a bipolar junction transistor. In short, the construction, various parts of BJT, etc. After that, we shall start the actual syllabus of second unit. Transistor connections. We have to study all the three types of connections of a transistor: common base connection, common emitter connection, common collector connection. We shall study in these connections how to make the circuit diagrams for the diodes, for the transistors, BJTs, when they are used in these three different connections or configurations. We shall have the mathematical relationships between various currents in the BJT and the expressions for current gains in BJT. After that, we shall study characteristics of these three configurations. After studying characteristics of these three configurations, when we go for study of characteristics of these three configurations of bipolar junction transistor, we have to study input characteristics as well as output characteristics of bipolar junction transistor in these three connections or configurations. After that, we have to study hybrid parameters or H parameters. We shall make use of two-port network for determination of H parameters or hybrid parameters. After studying hybrid parameters or H parameters, we shall use these H parameters for analysis of bipolar junction transistor amplifiers. For our syllabus, analysis of only two amplifiers is recommended: analysis of common emitter amplifier and analysis of common collector amplifier. While analyzing common emitter amplifier and common collector amplifier, we are going to use the hybrid parameters or H parameters of the transistor. And during the analysis of these two amplifiers, we shall study and derive the mathematical expressions for current gain, voltage gain, power gain, input resistance and output resistance of the transistor amplifier in common emitter connection and then in common collector connection. It is a somewhat big chapter. It may take more time. This will complete the second unit or second chapter. After that, the third chapter, electronics people may be familiar with the third chapter, third unit. Non-electronics people are not familiar with the third unit. Non-electronics people may be familiar with the diodes and with the transistors, BJTs, but they are not familiar with operational amplifiers. The third chapter, the third unit is about operational amplifiers. In this, we shall study what is basic circuit of differential amplifier, which is very important element of operational amplifier. Then, common mode and differential mode signals. There are two ways of providing input signals to operational amplifier, and these two modes are common mode and differential mode. We shall study both the modes, common mode as well as differential mode of signals. After that, we shall go for block diagram of operational amplifier, then the semantic symbol for representation of operational amplifier whenever it is used in any circuit diagram. After that, we shall study ideal characteristics of operational amplifier. Then we shall study input offset voltage, input offset current, input bias current, input impedance, output impedance, open loop gain, CMRR, common mode rejection ratio, slew rate, and last two articles are from applications of operational amplifier, and these two articles are inverting mode of operational amplifier and non-inverting mode of operational amplifier. This is about the third unit, which is completely new for you. When we start studying this chapter, I will go into every details of each article so that you will understood each and everything about the characteristics and these various parameters of the operational amplifier. And the fourth and last unit of this paper, sinusoidal oscillators. There are various types of oscillators: relaxation oscillators, multivibrators, sinusoidal oscillators. So for all syllabus, sinusoidal oscillators are recommended. We shall first have the definition of oscillator. What is meaning of oscillator? We shall talk about this. After that, we shall go for types of sinusoidal oscillations. In your syllabus, it is print mistake. It is typed as types of sinusoidal oscillators. This name is wrong. The actual name of this article should be types of sinusoidal oscillations. Okay. Then the next article is oscillatory circuit, then positive feedback amplifier oscillator, Berkshire criteria so that oscillations will be generated in the oscillator which will be sustained one. Then various types of sinusoidal oscillators, LC oscillators and RC oscillators. In LC oscillators, we shall study Hartley oscillator and Colpitts oscillator, and from the other category, we shall study RC network first. After studying RC network, which is also known as ladder network, we shall go for phase shift oscillator. This is about the syllabus of paper number 9. Let me have just introduction. The first article is semiconductor. First article is semiconductor. Semiconductor is a material. Name to this material, actually it is a crystal structure. The name semiconductor, this two material is provided because of its electrical conducting property. When we talk of electrical conduction, we generally divide the materials into three different categories: conductors, semiconductors, bad conductors or insulators. Whenever we talk of various materials for conductivity, electrical conductivity, we divide these materials in three categories. First one, conductors. Second one, semiconductors. Third one, bad conductors or insulators. What is a conductor? Conductor is a material which has good electrical conductivity. The electrical resistance offered by this material to the flow of electrical current through it will be very, very small, negligibly small. Such materials are known as good conductors. All metals are example of good conductors. This is because resistance of all metals at room temperature or at ambient temperature is negligibly small. Maybe fraction of ohms. Resistivity will be negligibly small. Such materials are known as good conductors. Second category of materials is a semiconductor. Semiconductor is a material which has conductivity between good conductors and bad conductors. Its electrical resistance will be much more than electrical resistance of good conductors and much smaller than the electrical resistance of bad conductors. It means that semiconductor is a material which has conductivity in between good conductors and bad conductors. In other words, semiconductor is a material which has electrical resistance in between good conductors and bad conductors. Such a material is known as semiconductor. Semiconductor is a material which has conductivity much more than bad conductors, which has conductivity smaller than good conductors. In terms of resistivity or electrical resistance, semiconductor material may be defined as that material which has electrical resistance more than good conductors and electrical resistance much smaller than the bad conductors. Such materials are known as semiconductors. Third category is bad conductors or insulators. Bad conductors can be defined as the materials which may have zero conductivity. No electrical current can flow through these materials. Ideally, we may assume that electrical resistance of bad conductors is infinity. As electrical resistance of bad conductors is taken to be infinity, no electrical current can flow through the bad conductors. The best example of bad conductor may be wood, dry wood, plastic, rubber, etc., etc. Because these materials do not allow any electrical current to flow through it, to flow through them, and therefore these materials are taken as the bad conductors or insulators. When we go for semiconductors, we will find a list of semiconductors. Silicon, germanium, carbon, and so on. From all these semiconductors, popularly used semiconductors are silicon and germanium. Now, why popularly used semiconductors are silicon and germanium? The reason is their conductivity and the feasibility to produce various electrical components using these semiconductors. These components will work as active devices, and therefore germanium and silicon are popularly used as semiconductors. For conduction purpose, what we need is free electrons in a material. Whenever there are free electrons in a material, that material will work as a conductor. When there are no free electrons, that material will work as bad conductor or insulator. When number of free electrons are moderate in number, smaller than good conductor, much larger than the bad conductor. Bad conductor will have zero free electrons. So, the free electrons inside the semiconductor will be much more than the free electrons inside a bad conductor. And therefore, germanium and silicon are generally used for manufacturing various semiconductor devices. Semiconductors have certain characteristics, certain properties. First thing, semiconductors have electrical resistance negligibly small as compared to bad conductors. All semiconductors are of NTC type. All semiconductors are NTC type, meaning that all semiconductors have negative temperature coefficient of resistance. It means that as temperature of a semiconductor is increased, its conductivity will also increase. That will reduce the resistivity. So, with increase in temperature, the resistivity or electrical resistance of semiconductors decrease. It is very important property. Conductivity of semiconductors can be increased by adding pentavalent or trivalent impurities. One part in 10 to the power 8 parts of the atoms of the semiconductor. that will enhance the conductivity and that will decrease the electrical resistance. Semiconductor devices are very popular. What advances, what progress we see today is just because of semiconductors. The various generations of computers, various devices which we are using are generally uses semiconductor components, semiconductor devices, and therefore study of semiconductors is very important. This is just about the introduction of semiconductor. In the next lecture, we shall go for types of semiconductors, and in detail we shall study what are the types of semiconductors and why germanium and silicon are popularly used as semiconductors for fabrication of various active devices. Till then, thank you.